All right, so we're going to do a circuit board evaluation of this Luxman RV-371 surround processor board. This is the second one that I have. I have rebuilt the other one already, but we're going to go across this one. I've already kind of taken some parts out and done some temporary repairs to it, but this board ultimately needs a recap, just like the other one. And it needs a few traces reworked. There's some broken traces, so we're going to put this under the scope and we're going to evaluate and see what might need some attention and what we're going to be doing to this board. So let's throw this under. All right, so initially, let's take a quick look. All right, obviously we see some traces that have seen some either high heat or corrosion, like this area here. Now, if I scratch it up a little bit, you can see the coating coming up a bit, but there's still trace under there, so we might be able to just clean this up and put some conformal coating down if the trace is still good. And we'll check continuity, of course. But it seems like the negative 16 volt and the positive 16 volt supplies of all these op amps seem to suffer from the same issue. Either it's excessive current draw, or I really don't know yet. But the other board did the same thing. Now I've pulled the regulator out of this already because I kind of needed it for the other repair that I did. So I got another regulator here. I ordered a set. It's a 5 volt regulator. And there's a part missing here I took from this board. This capacitor here. I needed that for repair of the other board. So we'll be replacing that too. All right, let's see what else. We have a little bit of heat issue here. We'll have to see what's up with that. Dig that out a bit. I think I also stole another resistor around here somewhere, or a capacitor. I think it was right here. Yep, right there. So I'll have to replace that. And this cap's going to get replaced. All these caps are going to get replaced. But see, this isn't even part of any circuit. It's just like a huge ground plane. Let's see if I can get focus back here. There we go. So yeah, so even though there's no current being drawn through this point, it still did the same thing. So I'm not exactly sure what these boards are suffering from, whether it was moisture or what. Keep looking around here. That's an IC that I've pulled. Want to get focus?
It must be way out in the scope here. Yeah. All right, let me adjust up here. That's the problem.
Okay, now we're starting to see what I'm talking about these supplies on the op amps here.
Notice how
both these op amps on the negative 16 volt supply, the coating is just corroded off of them. And you'll probably see that along this one, which I've attempted to repair already. So something is going on with this. This here, this is the one from the other op amp that comes down through here. And it goes underneath this capacitor, which I've had to do a pad repair on this because it was eroded so bad. Or corroded. So this one here is actually broken right here. If you notice, there's no copper in this. So we're going to have to put a jumper to restore this connection. And this one here, I think, appeared to be okay. Just missing its coating. So this area might just have to get rerouted and conformal coated over. This appears to be intact. This looks like a little issue I'm going to need to clean up here. Again, I think this is a power supply pin. And possibly here too. And I think this cap leaked. See, whenever you see on surface mount aluminum capacitors, when you really see this really fudgy, corroded legs, you can almost assume that these capacitors have leaked on their legs. And they're probably no good, need to be replaced. So, replacing this board, caps on this board, so no worries there. Yep. So we got a fair amount of work ahead of us here. There's some more caps that don't look too good. Let's go in for a closer look on these. Yeah, those legs look a little bad there. Yeah, we'll have to take care of that. All right, zoom back out a bit. This board, you can chase a ton of it around. It's just endless of damage. Oh, there's something that we're gonna have to take care of. Right there. This doesn't look too healthy. Let's go in for a closer look here. A bit scorched underneath there. I'm probably going to replace this resistor, at least pull it up and make sure I don't have anything shorting over underneath it, because it looks like this trace goes underneath and passes by it but doesn't connect to it. So I want to make sure this connection underneath here is good, and this resistor is good, and clean up any corrosion underneath there that might be growing. Yeah, see how this is not too bad? It doesn't have much green or fuzzy corrosion on it. This cap, you know, probably is okay, but I'm not gonna save it anyway.
There's a cap that's definitely got an issue there.
These legs are nasty.
Oh, there's all sorts of green fungus growing on that leg. Yep.
I remember scraping that. That was a piece of a trace that's almost ready to go. I remember seeing some of this stuff, this crap growing on here. And I started digging at it,
and this is what was underneath it. So I'm going to have to restore a connection across this. A little bit better than it is. Because if there's any current going through this, you can't imagine that little piece there
might end up snapping eventually. So we'll fix that up. Now the QFPs are okay. I've replaced this one already. This is a brandy new one. See, the trouble with these boards, these double-sided boards, is these. You see these little inserts here in the board? They connect this trace to a trace on the other side of the board. This is a connection between those two traces. And if these get damaged or corroded in a way that they don't connect through the board anymore, that'll definitely cause you some issues and not the easiest things to troubleshoot and find, because there's obviously hundreds if not thousands of these on these type of boards, like that. I mean, you can clean it up and try and inspect it the best you can and wring it out. But, I mean, if you were to test every single one, you could potentially be here for a very, very long time. So I just kind of go after the ones that are questionable, and I'll check them out with my meter. What you can do to restore them if they're not good is you can actually put... If you can get your iron on there and get solder to flow, put up some flux in there and heat it up and try and get some solder to flow through there. Sometimes that alone will just restore the connection. Clean up each side so you can get it to flow through. But if you can't get it to flow through, you might end up having to stick some kind of needle or a wire through there and fold it over to each trace on each side to restore the connection. I've had to do that on the other board with one of them. And, you can just, heat it up and slide a wire through at the same time. And fold the wire over and either wire it to a component that's nearby or, scrape this trace down and tack it down right at its entry point. The op amps look in better shape than the one on the other board. The solder connections look really okay. Not spectacular, but they're not growing shit on them. I'm concerned with this resistor here. It looks a little toasty. Again, the power pin. Somewhat corroded. And I think we're back to the beginning of the board here. Yep. Okay, so I mean, as you can see, there's a fair amount of work that needs to be done here. There's not much you can do with a lot of this stuff, with this corrosion. I mean, as much as you can do is you can chase it down and try and scrape it and like that. just get that loose crap off of there and maybe just put some conformal down over it. But for the most part, I think a lot of the traces are there and underneath it. So it might be okay. You can even clean it up, throw and tin up this area and then conformal coat it. So that's one thing you can do. As long as the connection is there, you should be good. It's not like this is going in the spaceship. So it doesn't have to be perfect. I mean, really, I mean, there's not much you can do. It's really not. You can't restore this. Best you can do is either reroute it, clean it up, and make it look as pretty as you can. I mean, yeah, that's. See, it's under there. The trace is under there. It's just seen some corrosion of some sort. Of course, I don't really have the right tool here scraping this down, but you get the idea. They are there for the most part, except for that capacitor here. You can definitely see this chunk missing out. So, and here's what I was talking about, the insert. You know, I mean, if this thing erodes away from the insert, you have to restore that. So,
okay. I think that's enough on this. I think the next part of this will end up being is stripping all these caps off this board and seeing how bad the pads under the caps are. And putting new capacitors on here. Restoring some of the resistors. Cleaning up as best as we can and jumpering up these traces where they're not making connections. And then after that, we'll put the regulator back in, put these ICs back in, and try it in the receiver again. But I can't see that being relatively soon because I'm still waiting on some parts, not a whole lot. I'm waiting on a few different value capacitors and some assortment of resistors, surface mount 0805s. So, yeah. So, you can stay tuned. I'm sure there'll be more videos on this coming up. So, that's it.